question. I really appreciate being here today and hearing everyone's opinions, values, etc. My name is Marie Elizabeth Gagnon, and I run the Parrot Sanctuary in downtown Toronto. I think what I would like to maybe just briefly contribute is that it is so important to understand animals and that we can't necessarily recreate their needs in a captive environment. Every day I have the reminder of, as working with parrots, that exotic animals, it's very difficult to look after them in terms of as a companion. And especially what I see is animals or birds that do things such as self-mutilation. And I think when you see the fallout of animals, specifically parrots, as companions, it's devastating to see that certain species really demonstrate their level of stress by damaging themselves voluntarily. So it's not so much, just want to put that out there, that I think a lot of times, if you look at behavioral science and studies, that a lot of people are very knowledgeable in how to care for animals, and other people are really not well educated enough to look after. I think it's important to have peer review and, to look at all the facets of it. But as much as I adore looking after parrots on a daily basis, it is very devastating to see the lack of education for these companions. So I'm not advocating to not have parrots as companions or what have you. But I think the education is really fundamental. I personally do not bring animals out to groups. I like to receive more private, not events, but people to come and inform themselves before they have a companion. But because it is, to me, a studies of one, certain animals, whether domesticated or exotic, may be able to have experiences outside of their, because we can't recreate their habitat. But I think for many it is very stressful to travel and I guess this, the overall not knowing, do you know your species and do you know how it exhibits the stress that is involved, and that it's not, you can love them to pieces in your mind, but how much is that animal getting from the relationship themselves? So I didn't come here with any formal sort of, but I just wanted to put that out there, that I think if sometimes people would see the outcome of animals who are non-domesticated or domesticated for that matter, I think any animal that you say is really easy to look after is probably not being cared for properly. And having children as well, and the level of empathy they've lived with parrots, with dogs, with all sorts of different creatures that we've had over the years as companions, I really see their level of empathy towards all forms of animals, whether it's wildlife, whether it's in Canada or all around the world. But I don't necessarily, I just don't feel that there's enough. There's a lot of stuff on the internet, but there's not enough really concrete, peer-reviewed, important education that is out there for people that have animals as companions. And I feel like if you're going to have a companion animal, it has to be a two-way relationship. It's not what you're purely gaining, is really recognizing if you're doing your best by